Alright guys, now let's do this day 17 of the Advanta Cyber 2 Frontier Hackme. That is about the reverse engineering, and we should do it using this Red Array 2 tool. So it's a disassembler and also decompiler and also debugger. But I am not that much familiar with Red Array 2. That's why I'm going to use the GDB debugger. I'm much more familiar with that. So this is all about the theory about the assembly language, and you can also check my videos for that, or you can read this theory. Okay, now we need to deploy this machine. You need to deploy this machine and SSH into that machine, and you need to perform the Red Array 2 operations. I have copied that challenge into my own desktop already, so that is the challenge one. So I no need to deploy this machine. I can directly debug using the GDB. And also it's in AT&T syntax. You need to convert to inter syntax. Okay, so we have this challenge one. We need to reverse that, and we need to answer these questions. So there are only three questions, very simple questions. We need to find the local variables and EAX value. So let's go ahead and do that. If you do not install GDB, you can install using this sudo apt install GDB. And also I have installed this GDB PEDA plugin, so it will display all the stack and register values after every execution. So you can use this two instructions to install the PEDA plugin for your GDB debugger. Okay, let's say GDB challenge one, and we can set the breakpoint using the break main. Now let's run this program, and now you can see push RBP and move RBP come RSP. So that is about the creating the stack for our main function. And now you can see moving one value into this RBP minus C. So that means RBP minus 12 bytes. That will be like a third variable or something like that. You can move down to the stack. You can see RBP value is FFD is this one. RBP minus C points to this one, I think so. Yeah, you can also use the calculator. So I think it goes up. Okay. Now don't worry, this is about the variables. So the variables are referenced by RBP minus the amount of storage it takes. So we are copying the one value into this RBP minus 0C. So we need to execute that instruction using the next. Hit enter. So let's see the question. So what is the value of local underscore CH when it's corresponding to the mover instruction is called first if multiple. Okay, so this is the instruction. So first instruction is move D word double word operation pointed at this address. So in Red Array 2 it may be identified as a local underscore CH or local underscore 8H or local underscore 4H corresponding to the variables. So this local underscore CH is similar to this one, RBP under minus 0xc. So we can just print the content of that variable, print RBP minus 0xc. Okay, we need to examine. So we are getting the address. So examine one byte in hexadecimal at RBP minus 0xc. So that is the one value. So that is the answer. And what is the value of EAX when IMUL instruction is called? So IMUL instruction is here. So we need to execute this instruction. So let's do the next. So we are copying the six value into another variable RBP minus 08. And the next, we are copying this one value into EAX. You can see RAX contains one. Alright, now what they are asking is what is the value of EAX when IVALUE instruction is executed. So we need to execute this one and check RAX contents, it's 6. So it's 6. And what is the value of local underscore 4H? Okay. So let's enter. So you can simply see from this 6 value is being copied into this RBV minus 04. That is this one local underscore 4H. You can say simply 6, or you can just hit enter and the instruction is executed. You can say examine one byte of, and print those bytes in hexadecimal, and then the location RBP minus 0x4, and hit enter, you can get the 6 value. So that is the value of this one. So you can say, you can also use the next instruction to execute next one, that is E0 is copied into EAX. So that's all about this small challenge. This is to introduce you to the red array, but I am not familiar with that. Maybe in future I may learn. So you can also do with GDB, so that's your wish, your wish, and that's up to you to use red array or GDB. So okay, that's all for this reverse engineering of this day 17 from Advent of Cyber 2.